again, I'm really sorry because I would have liked to have heard from them. So I just want their time to get started.
Children as human shields, and naive people who support the BDS movement are misdirected in their human rights advocacy. Because if they care anything about human lives, if they care about Muslim lives at all, they would be protesting the gender, race, and religious apartheid happening in every single Muslim-majority country in the world. But they don't care about Muslim lives. They don't protest female genital mutilation. They don't protest.
Palestine.
when they attempt to fundraise to provide direct material support to a designated terrorist group, Hamas, as they did at Rutgers, which is what the U.S. did Gaza and Baca did there, you have a direct connection between the BDS movement and not just anti-Semitism, but rampant violations of both civil rights and attempted violations of federal material support for terrorism.
Do you believe that the resolution as it's written, and this is just something that's come up often, but as it's currently written, do you think it precludes freedom of speech?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. There is nothing about this resolution. I know that Councilmember Cohen and those the drafters of this resolution labored very hard to ensure that this would not be violative of any constitutional law or principle, and certainly not the principle of freedom of speech. As we have said, it's just the opposite. For those of us who wish to be supportive of Israel, we're the ones whose speech is frequently compromised and interrupted. So the answer is absolutely not.
What each other is saying.
Palestine.
I'm sorry. Is someone still speaking out there? Because just raise your hand, and I'm going to ask the Sergeant Box to remove you if you feel the need to speak at this time. Okay.
How dare you!
Which is a call for a violent uprising, when they attempt to fundraise to provide direct material support to a designated terrorist group, Hamas, as they did at Rutgers, which is what the U.S. did Gaza and Baca did there, you have a direct connection between the BDS movement and not just anti-Semitism, but rampant violations of both civil rights, which is a call for a violent uprising, when they attempt to fundraise to provide direct material support to a designated terrorist group, Hamas, as they did at Rutgers, which is what the U.S. did Gaza and Baca did there, you have a direct connection between the BDS movement and not just anti-Semitism, but rampant violations of...
I'm here to also look at the proposed resolution in its entirety, and I want to take time to look at the wording of this resolution. Some of the things that were said in this resolution clearly indicate that it might not even have been one of the city council members on this panel that even drafted it. It might have been somebody from outside that gave it to them and let them offer it on their behalf. The first, whereas, the global boycott, divestment, and sanctions movement is a campaign seeking to exclude the Israeli people from the economic, cultural, and academic life of humanity. I mean, any person with the same mind can look at the statement and look at to exclude the Israeli people from the economic, cultural, and economic life of humanity. What does that even mean exactly? Does that mean that BDS seeks to exclude Israelis?
Jewish students are free to organize. They are free to call on the campus to disinvite me. They are free to advocate with their fellow students to not invite Linda Sarsour to come to their school. Because Linda Sarsour is an anti-Semite. That's exactly what happened. The students on the other side, the Black Student Union, the Black Lives Matter chapter, the Students for Justice in Palestine, organized and they were committed to me and my attendance to speak at their college campus. The point here that we're missing is that people who are pro-Israel have the right to stand up for the state of Israel. You have the right to say and feel what you want to feel as an individual. What I don't think that people have the right to do is why we are experiencing Islamophobia in this country. When you say the word movement, you are making it seem like we own something, like I got it in my pocket, or like I registered it here in Brooklyn, New York. This is a movement, a collective movement of people all over the world. These are people you are an Islamophobe. Like, this is the fundamental problem that we have.
Right. So I'm not asking you to say that I think that you're anti-Semites, which I do. And yet, you're entitled to your view, and I'm entitled to mine. But that's what started our conversation.
So if we are entitled to each other's views, but I'm asking
you are here as supporters of the BDS movement, and this resolution is about the BDS movement. You've chosen to subscribe to that movement, and that's what we're debating.
A resolution that chills free speech coming out of the Contracts Committee, although it was clarified by Councilmember Rosenthal that was in the resolution, which I am outraged that if somebody actually thought it should be in the resolution in the first place, but let's say that we do not want that. But that this can have chilling effect on nonprofit organizations, on Palestinian and Muslim and Jewish groups and civil rights groups and groups that do social services and communities of color who may have leadership or may want to engage in BDS. This could chill free speech. So what I'm here to say to you this, I'm not trying to convince you about BDS. You can think whatever you want about BDS, and that's cool, because that's why we're in America. But what I'm telling you is this is a conversation and a debate about free speech. Tell me that I have the right to BDS Israel 20 years from now, when I'm 60 years old, I might want to BDS another country. For God's sakes, I'll start a BDS movement against Saudi Arabia. This is about fundamental human rights and justice. Don't take my agency away as someone who stands for the human rights of all people in New York City. This is also a cadence to the people saying Black Lives Matter is a terrorist organization. Calling Black Lives Matter racist.
Campaigns on college campuses urging their universities to divest from companies such as, for example, Caterpillar Bulldozer, which is an American company, which is used by the Israeli army to bulldoze Palestinian homes. So that would be an example of
a
divestment tactic. It does not target individuals because of their national origin.
But it could also be, it's also a divestment tactic to not invite or block a speaker from an Israeli university not located anywhere in what we call the West Bank from speaking. So it covers lots and lots of things. And
you're saying a lot making a lot of statements that aren't based on any actual facts, and I really do recommend them, and I know the resolution doesn't actually have any footnotes, so I'm not sure where these statements are even coming from. I do suggest that you go to the National Committee's website.
To answer the question that you put to me, And I know you didn't answer my question, which is a focused legal question, but to answer the question that you put to me, despite what the last panelist said, it's true that the BDS movement is not winning in any way, shape, or form. There are almost no actual successes in terms of having an economic impact on the world or impact on the state of Israel. We are here today because your movement is creating a climate of, and an actuality of fear, anti-Semitism, suppression of the rights of those who are pro-Israel, and in many cases, they don't even have to be pro-Israel, they just have to be Jewish, to be able to go about their lives. That's really why we're here, to answer your question.
So I'd like to respond to you a little bit from my testimony. In Councilman Lansman, we don't agree on the Lord House, and I'm not going to get into that either. We're just not going to agree. I don't care to agree with you on that. But what I will say,
we of the Bible are here to express our opposition to those calling for punishment through condemnation of the global BDS Israel movement and its supporters and participants here in the world. Those wishing to condemn that movement have spoken with passion and eloquence today. We who support it hope and pray to do the same, an expression of our ethical obligation as Muslims to engage others mutually affected by the outcome of a decision. We do so in a Quranic spirit of sure mutual consultation as New Yorkers. We intend to address the issue at hand directly to the point, particularly speaking truth to power in the best democratic tradition. In 1930, when Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was just being born, and 2 decades before the Montgomery bus boycott, in the city of Chicago, a group of religious leaders, a Muslim community activist named Sufi Abdul Hamid, and leaders from the Black Church, instituted the tactic of economic boycott as a means for seeking redress to their grievances regarding racist hiring practices. Many other people have mentioned South Africa. So the only thing that we'll say about that is that when the BDS South Africa movement was launched, the white South African people opposed it. The South African government opposed it. Groups and organizations opposed it. The President of the United States, Ronald Reagan, opposed it. But eventually, that movement prevailed, and the result was a nonviolent resolution to what could have been the bloodiest race war in the history of humanity. The tactics of BDS have been used for years to pressure U.S. companies to stop illegally profiting from foreign occupations. Skipping the details, I'm just going to mention that on a global level, BDS, in previous decades, targeted South Africa's occupation of Namibia, Indonesia's occupation of East Timor. Right now, in Europe, there's a BDS movement directed against Morocco for its occupation of the Western Sahara. 15 years ago, here in America, Taco Bell was the target of a BDS movement because of its treatment of its workers. Right now, there's an environmental justice BDS movement that is in effect. So BDS Israel is not just a movement directed in isolation from these other movements designed to bring about justice. So, and lastly, I'm going to say that, as others have said, there's a wide variety. If I have more time, I'll give you the detail. There's a wide variety of religious groups right in America and around the world who have signed on to the BDS movement. Christian groups, long list, Jewish groups, long list, and some of them, she was Quakers or Quaker Bill, and the Quakers, they don't do the things that people have been criticizing again today. They have their own version of BDS, but under the wording of this resolution and under the wording of Governor Cuomo's executive order, even the Quakers would be condemned. So I want to, again, thank you. I, to be very honest, I debated as to whether I should even distribute copies of my statement. But because of my respect for the city council, and I've been testifying here for 2 decades on various matters, I will give you copies of our statement from the Islamic Leadership Council. We pray that you will read it and evaluate it. And we thank you for your time.
Thank you so much. And only because you raised it, I do want to thank the people who are remaining in the chambers for not interrupting any of the speakers so we can really hear what you have to say. And it was my pleasure to give the most recent speaker a lot of additional time. Thank you very much. If you could continue.